This is Shiko Maina. You're back again with an interesting topic. Please remember to subscribe, watch, share, comment, like. Yeah, thank you. So today I'm discussing about dating older men and what to expect when you date an older man. Okay, there are factors that you have to put into consideration if at all you see any future between you and the older man. Can I say older man? I mean, okay, as a young lady, maybe as from the age of 19 to 25 to 30, yeah, your time's approached by guys that are older than you, some your age, some even younger than you. So, you see, it's funny. People fall in love. You can't choose what age to fall in love with. So, before doing that, there are factors that you need to consider. And also, I'm not against dating an older man, no, obviously. But what I want to say here is, if it makes you happy, it isn't a factor. If it makes you happy, please do it. At the end of the day, it's your happiness that matters. So, I'll be highlighting about 7 or 6 factors. One, if you date an older man, you should consider whether he has an ex-wife or even children. Yeah, if he has kids, what age are they? What gender are they? Are they girls or are they boys? Okay, in most cases, girls are known not to accommodate the second wife very lightly, and they would not, at times, not respect them as it is supposed to be. The other factor is if he has an ex-wife, ama he has an already existing wife, ama he had a wife and they passed on, ama what is the urge to getting a second wife? Yeah, you should consider that so that you don't get into conflict. It is okay to know that, to prepare yourself psychologically so that you don't get harmed psychologically later in life. Number 2 is the emotional maturity. Basically, Ama definitely he has been in the game for a longer time than you, so he's likely to be more emotional intelligent than you, yeah, which is still okay. Don't be that person mwenye unamwambia tunafaa tuende party leo jioni. And he's like, no, I can't come. No, you should match his emotional maturity so that you don't get into conflict. Number 3 is your future trajectories and what you expect in future. As a lady, I'm a sisi wanawake, we're like, after school, I'll get married, I'll get a job, I get married, I get 2 or 3 kids, then, yeah, it's a done deal. Maybe I can go on holidays, I can go outside country and spend the rest of my life there. Yeah, you have those zile asthma za moyo wako zenye unafeel unafaufanye. On the other hand, maybe the man has been there, he has kids, he has been those places that you wanna go. Is he ready to do a repeat of that? Is he ready to allow you to do that together? Yeah, you should consider that so that you don't part ways in future. Number 3 is your sexual drive. In most cases, the sex drives for both parties differs. In most cases, which is still okay. In this case, we're having an older man. Maybe he's in his 40s, in his 50s, in his 60s. His goals are different. Okay, he has an older body. means an older man. Okay, an older man means an older body, less energy, and obviously less sex drive. Are you okay with that? Can you accommodate that? Yeah, you should consider that. The other factor you should consider is the communication language, or your love languages. Different people have different love languages. Yeah, there are people, if you text them, or you call them, or you buy them gifts, or you take them out, that's their love language. Yeah, maybe you are that person who want to be texted the whole day. You're that person when you upload a picture on Facebook, on Instagram, I'm on those platforms, you want your partner to comment. You should consider, are they ready to do that? Are they willing? Yeah, you should communicate, and you know what the other party is okay with. Because at times you may post, ama hata hawajaona, alafu nakasirika, and they even don't know. Yeah, you should consider that. The other one is your cultural gaps. Okay, we are the 21st century generation. We are not in, basically at his 50s, I'm at his 60s. You're not in the same generation. What drives you and what makes you happy may not match. Where you like spending most of your times may not be where he loves spending most of his time at. Maybe he's that person when you're up in a rumba, when you're up in a kutulia, yeah. But and you're that person who likes posting on Instagram, on TikTok, and up in a watch movies on Netflix. Yeah, like a weekend you can watch series and series. On the other hand, maybe he's not that type of person. Maybe he's that person when you end a rumba night, ama end a country music, ama some gazeti, asome vitabu. Yeah, you should communicate namjue where the both of you are going to meet for the sake of your relationship. Hi, number the other one is your financial responsibilities. In most cases, when someone is getting out of college and coming to the outside world and they secure a job, they basically head a student loan. So your finances, you'll be like, I buy clothes, I pay my loan, yeah, and that's all. I send my cash home, yeah. Yeah, you should be clear about it. You should talk about it. Maybe on the other hand, he has kids, he's supporting them in school. Yeah, he's doing all those things. Yeah, you should make each other aware of how you spend your finances. Atakama niza kopekiako, please let each other know how you spend yours so that you don't conflict. Maybe he has retirement benefits, maybe he's a CEO, maybe he receives pension, yeah, is of to zote. Let him let you know, yeah. The other one, okay, you might be lucky to have a man who is financially stable, who is really okay, and in most cases it happens. Men who go for second families are financially stable and they are doing okay. If you are lucky, well and good. If you are not lucky, that shouldn't be the end of it. You should agree and know what to do about it. Yeah, with that said and done, you're good to go. There are many more other factors, but those ones are the basic ones that you should put into consideration. Yeah, thank you for watching. Please remember to comment. Yeah, comment, like, please. Yeah, and even to share the topics that you would want us to discuss here. Yeah, thank you. Bye.